Hello everyone. In the last class we studied about the areas of similar triangles. What is the areas? Areas of similar triangles are proportional to the space of the corresponding sides. Am I right? And I solved some of the problems. And now one problem let me read out for you. The question is like this. D, E, F are respectively the midpoints of side AB, BC, CA and of triangle ABC. Find the ratio of the area of triangle DEF and triangle ABC. Now, the question is like this. There is a triangle ABC. A, B, C. D is the midpoint of AB. E is the midpoint of BC, F is the midpoint of AC. What is the area of, compare the area of this and area of this. Correct? Are they similar? Yes, definitely they are similar. You can prove it. They are similar. Right? Because the theorem says the line joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and half of the third side. So, this angle will be equal to this angle. Like that, you can prove that all these four triangles along with the bigger triangle is similar. Now, how to compare? To compare the triangle, I can take any one side. I say area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DEF. I say area of triangle ABC. I can say triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF, right? Therefore, area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DEF is equal to, say the corresponding sides, BC square by DEF square. Why? BC square by DEF square. What is BC square? Here BC square by DEF square. Why did I say BC square by DEF square? Last year we studied the theorem, the line joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and half of the third side. So, DF is parallel to BC and DF is half of BC. So, what can you write down? Area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DF is equal to BC square by DF square. I can write down half of BC the whole square is equal to BC square by 1 by 4 BC square. Right? So, BC square get cancels. So, area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DEF is equal to 1 by 1/4. Or I can say, if at all I can say, area of triangle ABC divided to area of triangle DEF is equal to 4:1. Am I right? So ABC is bigger, 4 goes up, 4:1. With that, I ask my own question. Now, this is ABC. D and E are the midpoints of AB and AC. If area of triangle ABC is 100 square centimeter, what is the area of triangle ADE? Again the same logic you have to use. Area of triangle ABC is equal to, this is D is the midpoint of AB, I said. E is the midpoint of AC, I said. You can use any of these sides. Area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DEF is equal to, what can I say? AD square by DB square. Right? So, this one is half of this. Again, what is AD square? ABC. Sorry, ABC means AB square. And this is AD square. Am I right? AB square and AD square. Or AE square by AC square. Or BC square by DE square. Anything you can write. So, what is AB square? AB square. What is AD square? Half of AB the whole square. So I can write down AB square by 1/4 of AB square. So AB square get cancels. So area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DEF is equal to, what is that, AB 1/1/4, right? ABC is 100 into 1/4 is equal to area of triangle DEF. Am I right? So what is this? 425, sir. So always remember, this is 1/4 of ABC, not half of ABC. That is the normal mistake we all do. If this is half, we say it is half of ABC. No, area of the similar triangles are proportional to the squares of the corresponding sides. This is also one type of question may be asked. One more type of questions: if the areas are in the ratio 81:56, then the sides are in the ratio how much? You have to find out the square root of 81. 9:2. What is this? Square root of 256? 60. You understand? So these are the types of questions normally appear for the exam. Whether I finished that criteria for similarity of triangles, but I see sometimes AAA similarity criteria they ask you to prove. When two triangles are equiangular, prove that the sides are proportional. Let me solve that theorem too. When two triangles are equiangular, then their corresponding sides, are proportional. This one we studied, but I did not prove it. Let me prove it. Whenever I say similar, I draw one bay. Let me draw one bay and another one small. So A, B, C and D, E, F. What is given you can write down. This is the theorem I am proving. Many a times it has come for the exam. So that is why I am proving. Even two triangles are equiangular, that means angle A is equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle E, angle C is equal to angle F. That's what you have to write down. Given angle A is equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle E, and angle C is equal to angle F. To prove. What to prove? Tell me. AB by DE is equal to BC by EF is equal to AC by DF. This is what you have to prove. AB by DE is equal to BC by EF is equal to AC by DF. Now, I want to construct something. Mark X on AB and Y on AC such that AX is equal to D and AY is equal to DF. Join XY. What is the construction? What is the construction I gave? Mark X on AB and Y on AC such that AX is equal to DE and AY is equal to DF. Join X. AX is equal to DE, AY is equal to DF. Join X1. Till here, did everyone understand? Yes. After that, let me go for the proof. In the proof, what I do is, first I take these two triangles and prove that they are congruent. What do I prove? They are congruent. How can you prove that congruent? Either any of the criteria, you know, SSS criteria, ye. What is that? It is not criteria we say. What is that? SSS postulate, ye postulate, all that we say, right? Yes. Now, in triangle, this is proof. In triangle ASY and triangle DEF, AX is equal to D, AY is equal to DF. By construction, we constructed like this construction. Angle A is equal to angle D by given. Three elements we got, then we can do that they are congruent. Therefore, triangle AXY is congruent to triangle DEF. What postulate? Yes, yes postulate. Am I right? Once we prove that they are congruent, I can say corresponding sides are proportional. Angle A is equal to angle D we used. Therefore, I can say angle AXY is equal to angle DEF and angle AYX is equal to angle DFE. And one more side, what is that? XY is equal to EF. When I prove that these two triangles are congruent, the remaining elements I can write, they are equal, and I can write down CPCT. What is that? Corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Now let me take this angle AXY is equal to angle DEF. But we know angle AXY is equal to angle DEF. Just now we proved. But what is angle DEF? In given, angle DEF is equal to angle ABC. Angle ABC. Therefore, what can I say? Angle AXY is equal to angle ABC. Similarly, I take like this. Angle AYX is equal to angle DFE. But what is angle DFE? Angle ACB. Am I right? It is, we have taken at in the given. So angle AYX is equal to angle ACB. Where is angle AXY? AXY is equal to angle ABC. This angle is equal to this angle, and this angle is equal to this angle. What do you mean by that? They are corresponding angles. When they are equal, I can say XY is parallel to BC. Therefore, I can write down XY is parallel to BC. Did you understand? I proved these two triangles are congruent, and I said the remaining angles are equal because corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. But I use that. Angle AXY is equal to angle DEF. But angle DEF is equal to angle ABC. Therefore, angle AXY is equal to angle ABC. Angle AYX is equal to angle DFE. But angle DFE is equal to angle ACB. That's what we wrote in the given. Therefore, angle AYX is equal to angle ACB. It is possible only when XY is parallel to BC. Once I write down XY is parallel to BC, I can use Thales theorem or reciprocal of Thales theorem, whatever I know. So I write down AX by ABB is equal to AY by ACB is equal to XY by BC. What is this? Reciprocal of corollary of basic proportional theorem. Instead of AX, can I write down D? Yes. DE by AB, because AX is equal to D, isn't it? So I can write down DE by AB is equal to DF by AC is equal to EF by BC. Can I write down like that? Yes. But what I wanted to AB by DE, that is, when I will take the reciprocal. Therefore, taking reciprocal, A B by D is equal to A C by D of is equal to B C by E of, and thus the theorem. The theorem is very simple. It may come for 4 marks to you. A X, A B C and D E of are similar triangles, and have to prove that when the triangles are equiangular, they are similar, and thus sides are proportional. You understand? What is my first to this one? I constructed one triangle similar to DEF and I proved that they are congruent, and I made use of the other elements and proved that this is parallel to this, and I used corollary of basic proportionality theorem, and thus I proved the theorem. I hope you have understood. If you like my video, please share it with others, and you please subscribe. Thank you, children.